Your class for 7 years. I am not enlightened.
I am not Sadhguru. This guy is a program running. Sadhguru program is running. How do you remove that? It's a language.
Okay. So I won't get enlightenment. Next question. Can I be enlightened all the time or it sometimes?
Who is asking the question? Tell me. The guy in your head. The guy in your head is not you. He is a product of the language, society.
But can we use it to solve our
Who is we?
I, can I use it?
Who is I?
The, I mean,
who is I?
There is two I's, right? Small I and the real I.
Is that two I? Who says two I's are there?
Small I is again created by the language.
But
we can use it to solve the problems, right? In the life. Take some decisions.
Whose life is that?
Mind,
whose mind is that?
My mind.
So you have a mind also?
I have a mind.
Who claims that?
I'm aware that there is mind, right?
I am aware, the guy who is aware is not the mind. There doesn't have the mind.
That doesn't have the mind.
So who are you?
I'm a knower.
Then what is the problem? Whose problem you are trying to solve?
Mind's problem.
Mind's problem, which you should solve.
Again, you got in trap.
Whose problem are you trying to solve?
Mine's problem.
Is it your problem?
No.
That is mine's problem.
So this is the trick created by a small guy. He makes you feel that you are the guy and you have to solve the problem. Okay? Actually, in reality, you don't have anything to do with the problem.
But there has to be some line drawn, right?
What is this line concept you tell me?
I mean, there is one part where language is troubling us. But there is one part also where language is like a tool which we can use to navigate.
This is a guy is entirely product of society.
Right.
Okay? Understand? There is a human child. There is a divine child. This is a society child. Now this society child is trying to solve the society problem. What is your problem? Your boss is a part of society problem. It's not your problem. Your wife is of course definitely part of society problem. Whose problem are you trying to solve? You tell me.
It's like a society problem and that's being solved by this guy. Who is also conditioned by the society.
Which can never be solved. Which can be only temporary patch can be given. Problem cannot solve a problem. That's why even after Buddha, Christ, Sri Krishna Paramatma, okay, Mahavira, Gautam Buddha, society is like that only. You can temporarily make some adjustment, some patch up work and do something and go ahead. First you have to understand this is not my problem. When you get enlightened, tell me. Geeta?
I'm already enlightened.
You're already enlightened. The class is over. I can relax. So, this guy creates an illusion that I'm not enlightened. Okay? And it is entirely product of language. The human child has 4 needs. Okay, human child also has problem. Human child by birth has 4 issues. Ahara, Nidra, Bhaya, Maitura. That means the food is a need for the human child. Nidra is a sleep. Bhaya means fear, survival. Okay, Maitura means sex. It has to produce itself. So these things nobody learns. It's born. That's the human child. Human child is basically driven by all these 4. The society child is driven by million things. Enlightenment is also around them. Enlightenment, liberation, God save me, how the God should be, what dress God should wear, okay, how God should look like. And you are God and my God,
Okay, already God is split into two, I and you, and that you God also split into my God and your God. And you see the language, beautiful. I get fascinated by the word. Oh my God, it's my God also. A part of the God is taken as my God also. Huh? The entirely it's a product of human language. That's why Ishwara says, Matrika Shakti. Then he says, there is a solution also. The language problem is created by language. Problem is also solved by language. That's called Mantra Shakti. The right word spoken, right word teaching is frees you. Frees you from the bondage of the language. Right? So what is the right words? What is the Mantra Shakti? Can you tell me? Can you tell me one mantra?
Soham.
Soham. Now people have become very wise. Who am I? Okay. Who am I? I am consciousness. Shivoham. So this is the language which will solve the problems which are created by the language. Okay. You understand? Otherwise, language is messing up with your head. Your head is nothing but a computer. And it's being programmed by the society day in and day out. Are you okay? Huh? So what spiritual enlightenment you are seeking? Of? Who is seeking? This fellow is seeking. You never had a problem. The divine child never had a problem. Who is asking the question?
Yes, I am already enlightened, but why we are trying to
enlighten? Who is asking the question?
Again, that.
So, it is very clearly said, the mind's problem, mind has a problem. Mind has no solution. The self has no problem. Okay? Mind has no solution because every solution you give, mind interprets in some way. Okay? I say that enlightenment is a, okay? What is that? Enlightenment is a solution for problem. Then you immediately start thinking, oh, enlightenment, it's not for me, appa. Okay? Enlightened person means you have to go to Himalayas. I don't have time to go to Himalayas. I don't even have time to go to movie. Okay? How enlightenment is possible? Yeah, enlightenment is only for great souls, no? Okay? Enlightenment, you should have a 1 foot long beard. My hair itself is falling, I can get a beard. So like that, you start creating a web. Oh, only Buddha can get enlightened. Okay? So, what happens is, all peddas means, pedda means Kannada, the fools. They say, how many Buddhas are there?
Yes, Buddha, we have Buddhas.
Buddha. Very difficult to get Buddha. Buddha, one Buddha comes in once in 2,000, 3,000 years. They'll say. But he asks Buddha, how many Buddhas are there? He says, everybody is a Buddha, appa. Everybody is enlightened. Now, the Peddha, a fool, is a creation of your language, my dear. Bondage is a creation of language. And language, the religion uses the bondage very effectively to make you put you into a stage of fear. You are a sinner. You have to do what I say. So, divine child has never a problem. The society child has no solution at all. Alright? It's always a patchwork you can do. You have to decide who are you. Clear, right? Any doubts? Atma Dnana. I am the self. I am the Atma. No, no. When will you become Atma? When will you become Atma? You tell me. When will you realize myself? When will you realize us? You are the self. Then, no. Self-realization must be, there must be some secret. See, there are people who say, the self-realization, they do the puja. See, you do the puja for Ramana Maharshi. Nobody does puja for me. That means puja, somebody has to do puja, then you are self-realized. So if that is your question, please come, I'll do that. I'll put a garland and I'll do aarti also. So you have such illusions you have built. by language, by this thing, what is Puranas, by biographies. Huh? What are you looking for? You tell me. If you are not looking for anything, the class is over. We are closing the class. Please understand, every time when you interact with your husband, you are not interacting. The fellow in your head is interacting with the fellow in his head. This fellow is a product of language. Who is interacting with who? Huh? It is like you are talking to your wife, you have switched on a tape recorder and she has switched on a tape recorder. Two tape recorders are talking to each other. You have never talked to your wife. The only language you can talk to each other is silence. You know that? I love you love me, I love you so much. Gone case, because this guy in your head is talking, he has a concept of love. Okay, his concept of love is the girl should be very beautiful, it should be like a film star. The girl said, this has a fellow like this. That girl's concept of the love is, this should have a thick pocket, no? Lot of money. Who is talking to whom? Have you ever talked to your husband, you tell me? Have you talked to anybody? Some machines in your head, programs in your head are talking to somebody.
Actually, we are not talking, but a lot of noises happening in the house.
Machines are talking. Artificial intelligence is not today's concept. It's very old. You never had intelligence actually. Uma, you have talked to anybody, Sean, any time in life? Huh? You don't know who says what? The noise in the head is talking. Okay, the only way to you can really talk to somebody is silence. Then you are talking. The universe is talking. God is talking. That is the only teaching which Meher Baba gave. And you have forgotten the teaching. I want to talk. Always wants to talk. And Meher Baba said, okay, you are not understood my teaching. Okay, go to hospital once. You will understand better. So now also you are not understood. I want to talk. What are you doing, my dear? Huh? The silence is the only language of the universe. Silence is the language of God. Silence is the language Meher Baba spoke. Yes.
Like, it can be in a form of job or you are getting salary or it can be in a form of relationship, everything.
All problems are.
You are very frightened to lose something.
And the fright is that guy, sir. The divine child has no problem, nothing will happen to that guy. Human child will get some injury.
But suppose if I leave my job, then it's a really bad decision, right?
I leave my job, what will happen to you? Yes, but what will happen is then if you are in deep silence, the universe will take care of you. Something new, beautiful thing will emerge. Much more beautiful. That this guy is not allowing to happen. Hello, Armisha. You there? Is there? The whole problem of enlightenment is problem of language, Sean. Have you heard of this teaching anywhere? Only Shiva teaches that. Nanam Bandha Matrika Shakti.
First book
head. That hit me like anything. People are sitting there like, what the, who the hell is that? ಅರ್ಥಾಯ್ತೇನೆ ಪುಷ್ಪ, ನಾನು ಯಾರು ಕೇಳುವರು ಯಾರು, ಹೇಳುವರು ಯಾರು? ಎಷ್ಟೇ ಏನು ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರವ ಓದಿದರೇನೋ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪುನಃ ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ ಆತ್ಮ ಅಂತ. ಮನಸ್ಸು ಇದೀವ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಹಾಂ ನಾನು ಆತ್ಮ ಕಣಪ್ಪ ಅಂತ. ಅಯ್ಯೋ ನನಗೆ ಇನ್ಯಾಕೆ ಸಮಾಧಾನ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ. ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಆತ್ಮ ಕಡೋನ್ ಶಬ್ದ ಆತ್ಮದ್ರವನಿಗೆ ಏನು ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತೇನ್ರಿ? ಹಾಂ ನಿಮಗೇನು ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ, ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತೀಯಾ?
The
mind's problem cannot be solved. It's perpetually a problem. You have to understand, I am not the mind. That is the solution. Oh, this is false life, is it?
No, I.
Real life.
Sometimes we say, I am the witness. Then there is also, we say, I am the operator. So these things are different things, witness and operator.
No. See, these are all, again, you have picked up from various sources. You have to pick up from one guru. Multiple guru, two words you pick up in their asaka. You have to be consistent in teaching. Okay? So now this language problem, you know, no guru will accept. They'll say only your karma, you have become taken a birth. They don't understand the language problem. their problem, their actual cause of rebirth is your karma. The cause of rebirth is not karma, because there's no karma. They will find out why. Okay, we'll go further. Okay, I'll just wait for this one. Who has to use the language?
Now, I is there, awareness is there, but we have a body, mind and intellect.
Right.
In which this I is there. Right. So, to use this body, we need to use language.
No, I'm not saying no. I'm saying there's no problem. I have a body is correct. I have to interact is correct.
Yeah.
What happens to I?
I is not affected by body.
The whole problem in life is you get stressed out because I is getting affected. I am stressed. I am the problem. The I part has no problem. It's the boss. This body, mind, and intellect is an instrument. That's forgotten.
So if I am aware that body, mind, intellect is an instrument, but still I have to use the language?
Yes. Your instrument screwdriver you are using for opening the fuse. The screwdriver is broken. What will happen to you?
No, I am fine.
But what's right now happening is, I have become the instrument.
So I should be aware, I should be silent at eye level, but I should use language for day-to-day.
You have to use the instrument properly.
Okay.
Right now you have become the instrument. You are confusing yourself with a screwdriver. Screwdriver is broken, I am broken. You understand? That causes stress in people.
Husband and wife are interacting, like tape recorders.
Yes.
Silence is the language.
Yes.
But without speaking, how will
you? No. Are you speaking? We'll find out. How the husband and wife speaks, I'll tell you. I have experience, okay? I have already 25 years married. I speak from experience. I don't speak anything from theory. So, Uma, you know how husband and wife speak? All of you have some 20 years of marriage. You know how husband and wife speaks. You people don't have experience, okay? We'll give a demonstration. You know, you have experience?
5 years.
5 years. Shashidhar Summa Bidhara. He says, husband never speaks. What is this? Prabhu is speaking, husband and wife speak. Husband never speaks. Fundamental rights of husbands are suspended after marriage. Constitution guarantees are withdrawn.
Huh?
I didn't type it with that.
I have come to a conclusion. Without marriage, no enlightenment. Marriage is the shortcut to enlightenment.
Direct path.
poor monks. They are looking for enlightenment in Himalayas right now.
Because you can get it home.
And there's a reason for saying marriage is a direct path to enlightenment, I'll tell you. Husband and wife speaking, okay, it's a big problem. The husband comes home, okay, the wife smiles. The guy in the husband side is already speaking, what happened to this lady? Today special smile, what is happening? Oh, the neighbor's wife wants a sari, this lady is also looking for a sari. So he has already concluded this guy in the head. Then wife, the guy in the head, wife's wife said, oh, this fellow, okay, is not responding to me at all. He must have seen some girl in the office. Okay, so all the discussions going on between each of these. Some 20 minutes discussions are gone. Already, no verbal, already they are talking to each other. The final conclusion, both are saying, okay, both, then finally one word, wife says, come, food is ready. half an hour discussion is over, in the head, nobody has discussed, these guys are talking to each other, the two different girls are talking, and sometimes the same thing happens when WhatsApp message goes to the husband, and husband gives a WhatsApp message, that happens in hospital, office also, house also, the conclusion. You have never talked to your husband. The only talking, real talking can happen in silence. If you are really in love, there is silence. Otherwise, the guy sitting in your head is continuously talking, chattering. What, Robin? Now what enlightenment? Who are you? And why did Buddha go to forest for 6 years to get enlightened? What did you do?
he found out this much only. Silence, right? So, a simple practice for you. Simple practice for you. When you go home, when you meet your husband, be silent and give a smile. Okay? Practice the language of silence with your husband. I have a little bit self-interest, so he'll get enrolled to next class for me. And he'll give you, encourage you, go to the class. He'll drop you here. Whether you get enlightenment or not, you understand that marriage is bliss. And now marriage has become less mess. Because the fellow is red. Sajani. Are you clear? So silence is the language of the universe. Okay? So that's why all the spiritual teachers taught in silence. You heard of this person called Dakshinamurti?
Yes.
Right? Dakshinamurti. He taught in silence. Now from this, what did you understand? What did you understand?
The guy which is there in our brain, which is continuously chattering, we should make that silent.
Silent. Who is we? I mean, you include husband also? Or next?
I am in
this class. Why are you? Already they have become silent. Why you want?
I should.
Who is that I?
Society. Big
guy
is there. Awareness. Uh-huh. And in the mind, this brain, the mind is
voice.
Picture was there. No?
Uh-huh.
That person is chattering always.
All right.
And the big I should make sure that this person.
Why big I should bother about small I? So, big I is always awareness. See, what's happening is you're actually. Awareness is going in, the small eye is taking control. The moment you become aware, the small eye becomes naturally silent. Your big eye doesn't have to do anything for small eye. Right? So now, have you heard of this Dakshinamurti story?
No.
Dakshinamurti, you have heard of?
Yes.
So what is this? Who is this Dakshinamurti?
Shiva.
Huh? Adi Guru. What is Adi Guru? So this is what how the web of language is created. Okay? Shravanamurti, Shravanamurti has heard the Dakshinamurti. Who is that Dakshinamurti?
Shiva. The I in you is the Dakshinamurti.
Ah, now he has been wise man. So, Dakshinamurti. Now, the moment you hear Purana, Dakshinamurti start imagining. Dakshinamurti is some person sitting in near the Himalayas. Very pleasing place. Tree is there. Then there are five rishis sitting nearby the person. And they are doing namaskara. Okay, Dakshinamurti is incarnation of Shiva. Okay? So, what a fortunate people sitting there. Okay, I am such a miserable. I am born in Kali Yuga. So, you start imagining. Right? So, Dakshinamurti means one who is facing south. Okay? So now, who is facing south? So, Shiva is facing south. It is not that south. South is actually, in Vedic literature, south means towards death.
Yama.
Again, Yama came into picture. One more fellow came into picture. You have to think one more fellow is buffalo also. So, Dakshinamurti means one who is facing south. Okay? So, Dakshinamurti means the big eye in you. The big eye. The awareness. Now, how is facing south? Awareness is all around, all places is there. So, how is facing south? When you are all directions, how you can face south? Is it possible? So when you are all directions, you can face south also. The south means direction of death. Okay? why is he facing some direction of death? This guy who is there, this small eye, is always running towards death. He is already afraid of death. Okay, he is constantly under fear. He is a jiva. He is constantly going towards death. Okay? Now somewhere he gets wisdom. If he gets enlightenment, he will become free. So then he faces towards the north. That means towards the Atma. Okay? So the Atma is waiting. Come my dear. That's why Atma is Dakshinamurti. Okay? And the guru who gives you the teaching of Atmadnana, he is the Dakshinamurti. Okay? So one who teaches you self-realization is called Dakshinamurti. If you don't understand this, you start imagining Dakshinamurti in millions of lifetimes also, you can't get Dakshinamurti because it's imaginary. Right? So guru teaches in silence. The real eye never does it speak anytime? The eye awareness does it speak anytime? It's silence only. His teaching is already on silence. And there are four fellows sitting near his leg. Right? With big, big beards. So because the moment you see beard, oh, big Rishi is sitting here. Because the white beard, no? This is old Rishi. So this guy is young Rishi. You understand? These are actually old people, means ancient souls. You are quite old. Okay. But no wisdom is there. So you are receiving the teaching. You have become very old. Jeeva, how old are you? How old are you? How old are you? There are three: human child, divine child, society child. Okay, what is the age of divine child?
No age.
What is the child age of human child?
My age. That is.
What is the age of society child?
Same.
What is that? What is the same?
When we are born, no? Right?
When you are born, who is born?
Huh?
Who is born?
Body.
Who is born?
Once again.
Human child is born? So what is the age? And I ask your age, what age should you tell me?
Don't know.
Uma. What's your age?
Don't know.
Huh?
Don't know.
Don't know. What is the age of divine child?
Eternal.
Huh?
Eternal.
Is no birth?
No,
no death? No aging. Okay. What is the age of human child?
Chronological age.
Some 30 years, 32 years. Right? What is the age of society child?
32.
Same, same as
2 years less.
No! Whatever is society is pumped into you! Since the beginning of society, all vasanas, all thought processes come to you.
Beginning of society.
That is that Rishi, old man. All society junk from some 10,000, 20,000, 30,000 years has come into your head. So who is seeking the teaching?
So all the knowledge is seeking.
That is that Rishi. That's why in this thing, Purana song is 10,000 is Rishis did tapasya. They don't know any action. Oh, then they'll say that they were great. 10,000 years used to live. Yeah. They are only living 100 years. They don't understand. 10,000 is not about body. 10,000 years society junk which is coming to their head. Have you understood?
Yes.
Are you clear?
Yes.
This is the way Puranas are twisted. Misunderstood. So the moment you misunderstand, your search goes in some other direction. Somebody is saying, I am going where? I am looking for cave of Dakshinamurti. I know another person who is doing sadhana. Okay, he says when he has become a wandering monk. He says, I have been a wandering monk. Okay, every time I go, I search for a cave to do meditation. Okay, so now this is another corruption which has committed. Ya in hridaya guhayam nihitam guhayam, the self is hidden, the cave guhayam, but that's not the cave, that's the cave of the heart, which is intellect. Okay, this people don't for meditation in the cave.
Already it is there.
We go to caves. I know a person. He says, I only met in a cave. And he goes from place to place and monk.
Such as for the caves.
Enlightenment can happen only in cave. That's what he clearly said. Yes, enlightenment can happen only in cave, but this is cave of the heart. You understand? Huh? And all enlightened people are only found in Himalayas. Actually, if you look at any of the popular autobiography of yogis and everything, yeah. If he has not gone to Himalayas, he cannot be called as a yogi. Mm. I mean, it's like a brand image, right? Brand,
Harvard.
Like Harvard. Okay, if you have to, if you are supposed to be enlightened, little bit, not in one degree, okay, then you should have spent 2 years in Himalayan caves. Okay, right? Have you heard of that? Without going to Himalayas, nobody can be. And by that factor, I can't be anything. Okay? But at least I have simulated 21st floors. Slightly elevated. Okay? So this actually Himalayas, they told in a very different way. Okay? What they said is, Himalayas, snow white. Okay? And frozen. Okay? So, for our ancestors, the person who reached the peak of mind is called Himalaya, top of Himalayas. In modern English language also, he got his promotion, he is on top of mountain.
Yeah.
Alright, the language comes. Yeah. Right? On top of mountain means what? Oh, he has gone and sitting top of Himalayas, right? Our ancestors said, a person who is Jnani, he is on top of the mountain, which is Himalayas. For them, Himalaya is the top of the mountain. So now you have already started. Without going to, if you want to beat Jnanis, you have to go to only top of the Himalayas. This is how the society is working. And no world, it's the, no world, the rishis has become very old. 10,000, 20,000 year old. Are you clear? So this is how society myths are cleared. And who creates this society myth? The language. And who is seeking enlightenment? What has happened to you? Huh? You are already divine child. You are already consciousness. Nanu.
Nanembudu.
Nanalla.
Ideha.
Manabuddhi.
Nanalla.
Sachidanandatma.
Shivananunani.
Shivoham. Shivoham.
Shivoham.
So you have to recognize I am the divine child. No, it doesn't even say you have to become the divine child. The moment I say you have to become, then you are gone. Then you say, how many steps are there? Okay, which place Himalayas to go? Hey, Himalayas is very difficult to go. I go to next mountain, which is a little bit smaller. I have a very asthma problem. This is how the Karma Yoga came into picture. So they said, you are Brahman. Okay, the Karma Yoga is converted, you have to become Brahman. Over! This is how the path of Karma Yoga came into picture. Understand? To become you don't have to do anything. All that you have to do is you have to get rid of the society fellow. You don't have to get rid of the society because that guy doesn't cause you trouble. You have to understand the game of the society fellow. ಅರ್ಥಾಯ್ತೇನ್ರಿ? ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪಾತ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ಲೈಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್? ಧ್ಯಾನ ಮೂಲಂ ಗುರೋರ್ ಮೂರ್ತಿ, ಪೂಜಾ ಮೂಲಂ ಗುರೋರ್ ಪದಂ, ಮಂತ್ರ ಮೂಲಂ ಗುರೋರ್ ವಾಕ್ಯಂ, ಮೋಕ್ಷ ಮೂಲಂ ಗುರುಕೃಪಾ. ಸೊ ನೌ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಮೋಕ್ಷ, ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್? ಧ್ಯಾನ ಮೂಲಂ ಗುರೋರ್ ಮೂರ್ತಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಥಿಂಕ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಗುರು. ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್? ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಗುರು, ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಪುಟ್ ಎ ಫೋಟೋ ಎವ್ರಿ ಡೇ, ಐ ಲೈಟ್ ಎ ಲ್ಯಾಂಪ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಗುರು. ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಗುರು ಇಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಲೆಸ್. See, your directly method is told. Now you are converted into your own idea. Oh, my guru form. See how nice. And one, I have heard many people. See, my guru's form. I do puja of guru form every day. Okay. See his eyes. He is enlightened. Enlightened means the light is coming from eyes. I am trying to see where is the light. Okay, then I say, okay, can you switch on that light? I can. This is how human mind is working. Okay, dhyana moolam guru or murti. Form of guru is, may you have to meditate. Form of guru is formless, which is chaitanyam, which is I. Okay, puja moolam guru or padam. You have to worship the feet of guru. I understood. I have to catch hold of the feet of the master when he comes home. I know one guruji. He is very afraid to go to ashram. Okay, there is one shishya there, one lady, okay, 60 plus 70 plus. That lady, she has understood very clearly, puja moolam guru padam. When guru comes, she holds up, catch holds up feet. Guruji, unless you give me mukti, I will not leave your feet. So Guruji is afraid to go to ashram. This lady doesn't leave him at all. Pooja moolam guror padam. Guror padam means feet of the master. Okay, feet of the master is his path. He walks on the path of jnana, clarity, wisdom. That you have to catch hold of. Wisdom you have to catch hold of, not feet of the guru. Pooja moolam guror padam. Mantra moolam guru vakyam. No. If you have to get liberated, you have to catch hold of mantra. Then you have so many mantras. Oh, you know greatest mantra? This mantra, that mantra, and mantras are sold at 10,000 rupees, 5,000 rupees, $5,000. Okay, there is one Guruji sells per mantra initiation $5,000. Okay, so and that also Bijakshara mantra, cream, clean, one mantra $5,000. Mantra is not that. Manana trayati iti mantra means, mantra is not chanting. Manana trayati iti mantra means once you understand clearly the essence of mantra, you are free. It never said mantra has to be chanted. Now everywhere ashrams you convert mantra chanting 10,000 times, 20,000 times. Mantra is not about chanting. Mantra is about understanding the essence of the mantra. 1,000,000 times also you chant, you can't get the essence. What it? See, 1,000,000 times you chant a mantra, it doesn't mean, it gives a diversion to the mind. It is a diversion to the mind. Okay, society child is happy, I am doing something. That doesn't solve the problem. Okay, mantra moolam guror vakyam. Mantra is not a sound, magical sound. The teaching guru or vakyam, the teaching which guru gives with the clarity which he gives is like a surgery. Okay? That surgery is mantra moola. Guru doesn't give you mantra. Chant this mantra. The word of the guru becomes mantra which will destroy the matri maya shakti. Mantra moolam guru vakyam. Moksha moolam guru krapa. Grace of the Guru is liberation. What is the grace of the Guru? The clarity in teaching, the precision in teaching is moksha moolam. No, I got Guru's grace, I'll get moksha one day. Then you didn't get it. either you have got the clarity or you didn't get the clarity. After 10 years you can't get the clarity. It has to be clear. Now. Sounds good? Everything has been twisted in society. Something clear? Sounds good? Kuch samajh aa gaya? Okay. So realize I am that I am. Now you see here, I am is small, that is capital, I am is capital. Okay. So this distinction you will not find in any books because they don't know what is I am that I am. I am that I am. Is it? Okay. So you have to understand clearly. Alright. So read the books where it says I am that I am. See the spelling, the way they put, then you'll understand whether that person is understood or not. The I am is small, that has to be capital, I am has to be capital. It's called Shivoham. Why is that so? You'll find out.
Concept is the same as Vedic.
Yes.
Everything is within the small I am is this, and anything that's not within the small I am is that.
Huh? Same. That. We'll find out. We'll find out. Right? So, first you have come here to get what you want to get. Why you come here all the way from which place?
Experience realization.
Huh?
Experience realization.
Experience realization. How do you experience realization? A, one day you get enlightened. How do you know that you are enlightened? Huh? You understand? I want enlightenment. Actually these are all my safeguards, okay? So after 10 months, I have still not got experience. That's what people say. So that's why I put all disclaimers in the beginning itself.
Very differently, enlightenment.
So Mugita, class Mugita. Huh? Oh, Mugita. Uta maadu uta hogide. What's such name? What is enlightenment experience? Buddha must, something must have blown in his head, no? Some bomb or something. He declared, I am enlightened, Vaishakhi. Buddha Purnima day got enlightened. Something must have happened to him. What is that happened to him?
Nothing happened. He just realized that all these years that he went around from master to master, what was the point?
He understood the futility of search for enlightenment.
Yes.
Who is searching for enlightenment? It's the society child. So he understood this stupid fellow. He is taking me on the hard way. Are you clear in the Gita? Huh? Are you clear? There must be this Guruji must have some special experience. That's why he's Guruji. Why I am like this? So there must be some special experience, no? Huh? You read any scriptures? This saint got this experience. Some light came. Some light bloomed. Down. No.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. I
heard
so many.
I heard the TV also.
Yeah.
Okay. The
yeah,
God, the God will come. On light will come. The God will come in front of you. Huh? Some special experience must be there, no?
Maybe.
Huh?
Maybe.
Written like that now.
Ah.
Some light has come.
So I have written how Dakshinamurti has been made into what he is. I have told you. How saints can report the Himalayas also, I have told you. Now enlightenment experience also like that. Okay. So let me understand first then. Is there a spiritual experience and is there a material experience? Is there a difference between the two? I want a spiritual experience, no, Uma? Very important, no? To have spiritual experience. Right? Some spiritual experience is very important in life.
It's labeled that. That's all.
Now you become smarter. Pushpa, what spiritual experience you want in life? Huh? Some spiritual experience you want, no? What, Robin? No, no, you don't want.
So
what is the difference between spiritual experience and material experience? Is there a difference between spiritual experience and material experience? Shishidhar? What is the difference between spiritual experience and material experience?
Material experience is temporary.
Huh?
Spiritual experience is permanent.
No change in
that. Then what are you searching for? Permanent is there, now forget it. Why are you searching for something?
Huh? And spiritual experiences for the big guy.
Big guy?
Sakshi.
So, people say, no, this person is materialistic, I am a spiritualist person, I have become a monk and I have a dress. Okay, this person is spiritual, this person is material and all those things are saying, no. Are you spiritual or material? Materialistic?
I need to find
out. What about you? How many people are spiritual? Spiritual people are there here? Are you?
I don't need anything. Huh? No, no wants.
Sometimes
ah, when you are spiritual in the bar, you are spiritual in the. When you are spiritual, you are material.
In the class, you are spiritual.
So, what is the difference between spiritual and material?
Stop. Thoughts also stop.
Spiritual is becoming.
Thoughts are stop means stone.
No wants.
The stone is very spiritual.
No wants.
The stone is very spiritual. Right? There's no thoughts.
No wants also.
Yeah.
No wants.
The highly spiritual is a mountain.
I don't want to go to mountain already.
No. Mountain is spiritual because no thoughts.
Mountain.
So, Shravan, what is the difference between spiritual experience and material experience? Who is spiritualist and who is materialist? Are you spiritual? First let me ask you, are you spiritual?
I'm spiritually materialist.
So, the people say, another say, this guy is a materialist, this guy is a spiritualist, I am a, what is that? This guy is a divine person, that guy is a, after money, all those things are there, no? So what is according to you spiritual and what is according to material? Sajini must be knowing. You have logged in so many hours of
it's a process of removing everything.
Dropping.
So according to you, what is spiritual and what is material? Which of you? You have to choose now.
Can't choose both ways.
Why?
There are times when I feel spiritual, there are times I feel materialistic.
Ah, you tell me when you feel spiritual and when you feel material. You tell me.
I feel spiritual when I'm more with the nature.
Uh-huh.
It somehow tells me that this is oneness with the nature is oneness with
who
myself.
Says so?
Myself.
Who says so?
I say.
Who is I?
I the big guy.
The big guy doesn't say anything. It is a silent.
Yeah, it's a silent. True. But it just gives you the feeling. It's just the feeling.
Who gets the feeling?
Me.
There are three children.
Yeah.
Huh?
The spiritual.
Spiritual
child. The divine child.
The divine child, does it talk?
No, it doesn't. It just gives you
a... Does it change?
No.
So does it experience something special in any point of time?
No, that's why I'm saying no, it's not constant. It happens sometimes.
Who is
What is spiritual experience? See, without understanding this, we go after spiritual experience, which is illusionary. Okay? Life is neither materialistic nor spiritualistic. Life is divine. There's only one experience, we call it as different names. When I eat a banana, okay, let me eat a banana. So, I'm eating a banana. Now tell me, is it a material experience or spiritual experience?
Materialistic for your body.
Is this a materialistic experience or spiritual experience?
It's just an experience. It's
so then what is spiritual experience? Nothing. See, everything in life is an experience. Okay? Life is nothing but a set of experiences. Yes or no? This experience or that experience? Is there something good experience or bad experience also in life?
Yes.
To the mind.
There is no good experience, no bad experience. There is no spiritual experience, there is no material experience. That naming is given by the language product, the guy who is sitting in the head. Life is a set of experiences. Okay. There is an experience. There's an experienced, there's an experience, and there's an experiencer. There are three. Right? Experiencer, experienced, and experience. Right? So this is told in terms of Brahma, Panam, Brahma, Havi, Brahma, Agno, Brahma, Navatam. There's an offering, this being offered, and somebody whom the known is offering. There are three. Any aspect of life has three. The seer, see, and process of seeing. The doer, doing, and some of the result. So this is called triputi. Three. Right? Triputi is there in any experience. Three aspects are there. Right? Now, if you ignore Atma, ignore the self, who is the experiencer, real experiencer, everything is materialistic. So, when you say, I enjoy banana, Gayatri, when I enjoy banana, who is this I?
Big guy.
No.
Which I is this?
Experiencer.
Who is this I? I have only three children. Which child is enjoying this banana?
Human child.
The moment say human child, it becomes materialistic experience. Yes. Human child is a part of
matter.
Okay? It became a materialistic experience. Okay? Now I ask the question, can human child experience a banana? Can human child experience a banana?
But except for the sense organs, what else can experience?
We'll find out. Can human child enjoy banana? Pushpa? Robin?
Yes.
Yes? Can human child enjoy banana?
Yes.
If the divine child is not there, can human child enjoy banana?
No. Divine child has to be present for that.
What is the role of divine child and what is the role of human child?
Human child is the instrument of
divine child. The moment you ignore the divine child, every experience becomes materialistic. The moment you bring in the divine child, every experience becomes divine experience.
Right.
Understand? The banana, eating a banana cannot happen without the divine child. Okay.
The divine child
has
a consciousness
also? Yeah, if the consciousness doesn't come to the body, how body can eat?
Okay.
Right? So divine child gives the consciousness to the body. But is divine child eating?
No.
The human child is eating because of presence of divine child. Okay? What is divine child's role and what is human child's role in this eating?
Divine child's